today, the merciful God, we have the chance celebrating the sainthood of our mother in this world of virtue. I joined the society in 1974 at the age of 19. I have not only one sainthood mother. I was longing to see her. The day came when I met her in Calcutta. I was lost in my mind. I was looking at her, but Mother came with shoulder cross and the rosary to give us the blessing. And she gave a small instruction. I remember four words up to now. God loves you so much. You are a gift of God. And you are belongs to God. That's why He has called you to love, serve in the poorest of the poor as a missionary of charity. Are you all happy? With one voice they said, yes, Mother. And we were a big group. And we were sent some to take care of the babies, some to self schools, some to the mobile dispensary, and we were, some of us sent to the first school Mother opened for the dying destitute, Nirmala with the pure heart. The first site where I went to see, I was confused. Five to six dead bodies daily, and admissions 10 to 12 daily. I was afraid, will I able to continue forever? But Mother very often visited that home, and she helped us to serve, how to love, how to care the patient. When we stand far away seeing the migrants of the patients, or dirty, she used to come. My child, bring this. My child, wipe this. My child, cover this. That moved me. And Mother knows, even though she was very late to bed after her writing work, she will be the first one in the chapel for the morning prayer with a loud and clear voice. And Eucharist was the main center of her life. There I saw, nothing and nobody can disturb her when she is praying. That belonging to Jesus and love for Mary was a real wonder. And she was her community. The bell was the voice of God for her. For means, for recreation, for common gathering, for to give blessing for us in the morning, she will be the first one near the gate. And while giving the blessing, she will look at us, our face, if we are sad or sick. She will call the doctor sisters and she will tell, take care of her. Today we don't go out. That was Mother's love. Always available to the sisters. Beside the morning blessing, at any time we can run to her to take that blessing. Just she will drop the pen on the table and she will give blessing. My child, God bless you. That was for us a TLC tablet, tender loving care. And in 1977, before my boss, I was very sick, miserable, not able to eat, and not able to do my normal life. Then noticing that, the sister in charge told me, come here, you have to go back home. And we had a chance to go and see Mother. Well, I came here. I went near Mother. I sat opposite of her stool. She put her right hand on my shoulder and she looked at me closely and with a smile, with a compassionate heart, she asked me, are you all right? Yes, Mother. Are you keeping well? Yes, Mother. You are eating well? Yes, Mother. But my child, you are so weak. Our work is very hard. I think I will give you a letter to join the other congregation at Calcutta and there will be not much hard work. Would you like to go? For a moment I was right. Then I said to Mother, child, you will eat well and you will continue this work. And now I am allowing you to take your voice. I cannot express today the joy that I felt that day. The compassionate heart of acceptance of mother still today moves in me. That's why today as an MC I am in front of you. I thank God they have chosen me through mother. And always he says, you will do with Jesus, for Jesus, and to Jesus. This is all the time when I am not able to. Life is a challenging till today. But as a constitution she has written, but she was practical for us. That made me to continue. And I want to tell you,